Hi, this is Professor Kleitz. A lot of you have probably seen the application where you use an Arduino to measure the voltage off of a wiper from a variable potentiometer. I'm going to use this application to talk a little bit about Ohm's law. So I'll use the TinkerCAD to simulate this operation. First of all, let's take a look at the code. And in the C programming, what we see is the initial setup where we're going to set up the serial port at 2600 baud so that we can look at the voltage that we're getting off of the wiper from the potentiometer. And then within the endless loop, we're going to read the analog value on analog input 0 and enter it into a variable integer called sensor value, and then we're going to calculate the voltage based on the fact that the analog reading can be anywhere from 0 to 1023. That number comes from the fact that it's a 10-bit analog to digital converter, and 2 raised to the 10th power is 1024, which is 0 to 1023. Anyway, so to calculate the actual voltage, we're going to convert it to a float value instead of an integer. We're going to take that binary value that we just read and multiply by this ratio, 5 volts, which would be the maximum output, divided by the maximum binary number. Now, this ratio multiplied times the binary value that we read on analog input 0 will convert into the voltage. And then we'll just print that voltage out on the serial screen, wait 10 milliseconds, and then go back and redo this loop again. So let's take a look at this. If I run this simulation, actually we have to have the code on. We watch the serial monitor and we'll start the simulation. And as I turn the potentiometer, by turning this potentiometer here, we'll get different values on the serial monitor. So if we look at the circuit diagram a little bit, or not much of a circuit diagram, but potentiometer, we take the red lead, which is on the left end of the potentiometer, and we run that right into the 5-volt supply from the Arduino board, and then the right hand of the potentiometer goes to ground. So we've got 5-volt potential from end to end. The wiper, as you turn the wiper on the potentiometer, the value is going to set up a voltage divider and send that voltage into a zero. So let's talk a little more detail about Ohm's law, and we'll discuss current, ohms, and volts, and then we'll get into how the voltage divider is set up. So the three terms used in Ohm's law is voltage, current, and resistance. So the voltage, the abbreviation we use is a capital V, and the unit is volts, and the symbol we'll just use a capital V again. Current, the abbreviation is I. And the unit is the ampere, and we're also using a lot of times milliamperes, which is 1/1000th of an amp, and the symbol for that is capital A. Resistance is abbreviated R, and that's an ohm is the unit, and that's a Greek omega. And with ohms, a lot of times we use kilo ohms, which is thousands of ohms. So in other words, 1 kilo ohm is 1,000 ohms. So the actual equation for Ohm's law is I equals V over R. So the current that flows in the circuit is equal to the voltage applied to the circuit divided by the resistance. Now, in words, it's stated that the current in a circuit is directly proportional to the applied voltage and inversely proportional to the resistance. So from that equation, you can see that if the voltage is doubled, the current would double. If the resistance is doubled, the current would be 1/2 because it would have a harder time getting through the circuit. So let's do a couple simple calculations. Let's say we had a 12-volt supply voltage and the resistance was 6 ohms. The solution for this question A would be, well, you use the equation I equals V over R, and we have 12 volts, 6 ohms, do the math, and it turns out to be 2 amps, which can be written as 2A. Now, in the second case, we're doubling the voltage, and so now we've got 24 volts over 6, and we'll end up with 4 amps. And I say here that notice when the voltage was doubled, there was more pressure to push the current, so the current doubled. C, let's leave the voltage back at 12 and increase the resistance. That should decrease the current because it has a harder time getting through the circuit. So in that case, 12 over 12 ohms turns out to be 1 amp, which is 1 half. And then if we then take the resistance and make it 24 ohms in part D, that cuts the current in half when you do that math. Notice that when the resistance is doubled to 24, the current was more restricted and it dropped in half. But if we use algebra, we can rearrange that equation, and this I equals V over R, we could rearrange it and get V equals I times R. And with a little algebra, we could also come up with R is equal to V over I. So here's a few more examples. Why don't you try these on your own? If we're given the voltage of 12 volts and the current of 6 amps, find the resistance. And then part B and C. Try these four. You can put this on pause for a moment, and then I'll pull the solutions up after you've taken a minute to try this on your own. And here are the solutions for part A, B, C, and D. Again, hit pause and go through this. Make sure you understand how that is. Now let's flip back to the Arduino circuit and take a look at some actual applications. So the Arduino that's in the TinkerCAD has a voltmeter. And let's take a look at the voltmeter connection. And we'll drag this over. It's actually a voltmeter, ammeter, and a ohmmeter besides. So we'll connect up the red lead over to the positive power supply from the Arduino, and we'll hook up the ground lead to the ground, and we'll just double check what these voltages are. So I run the simulation. It runs up, so it's 5 volts. So let's put a resistor in the circuit and try out some Ohm's law experiment. So I'll hit stop there. So a basic resistor, first of all, let's get rid of this red lead. And I like to use red for the positive and black for the negative. So now drop this resistor in the circuit. And we'll actually hook this up as an ammeter. So now it's in series, and all the current will come out of the plus 5 through the ammeter and back up. So the resistor that we have here, if I double click on it, it is a 1 kilo ohm resistor. And we can look at the color code on it, brown, black, red. And you can look up color codes for resistors on the internet, and you'll see how that all plays out. So if we put the multimeter in the current mode, which is A for amps. I have to be running a simulation first, I think. So put this in the amp mode, and it comes out to be 5 milliamps is what we expected. 5 volts divided by 1 kilo is 5, and the fact we're dividing by a kilo, which is 1,000, it turns out to be a milli. So it's 5 milliamps, which is 5/1,000th of an amp flowing. And the last thing we might want to do would be to measure the resistance of that resistor. So if I delete this one wire and just hook up the multimeter to ohms. So we'll connect this wire over. To measure ohms, all you do is just put the leads right in parallel with the resistor. And I'll put this on the ohms setting. We'll run this, start the simulation, put this on ohms, and it should say 1 kilo ohm. There it is, 1 kilo ohm, same as 1,000 ohms. So that was a brief introduction to Ohm's law. So in our next video, what I'll talk about is how the potentiometer acts like a voltage divider circuit. And besides using a potentiometer, you might also have some other sensors in there, like a pressure sensor or a temperature or a light sensor. And generally what we'll do is put those in series with a resistor and set up a voltage divider to determine the change in resistance of those transducers and bring those into an analog input. So I'll cover that in the next part of this Arduino series. So signing off for now.